Hey guys, how you doing today? It's me, Kelly. So today is the third day of Love Summer Art. And today I'm just going to play and do some mixed media. Very simple, nothing major. It's what I do when I'm stressed out. I love to relax and do mixed media. It's just very freeing to me and very emotionally freeing as well. Please go to the search in YouTube and put in hashtag Love Summer Art or do it on Google, and you will find hundreds of artists out there from A to Z. You can find crocheters, knitting, fabric artists, to mixed media artists, to acrylic artists, to watercolor artists, to clay, it just runs on and on. So please check it out. And if you're new to my channel, welcome. I'm so glad to have you here. Leave me a comment and let me know that you're new, and let me know if you guys want to see anything, if you guys have any requests. I'm really into doing beginner clay right now, so I have quite a few of them coming up, but right now, let's start with the mixed media. So, mixed media to me is, like I said, it's phenomenal. It is very soothing, and it's a very creative way to, just to help when you have anxiety or, you know, you're not in a great place or you're not inspired, because a lot of us get uninspired, and this is a great way to do it. All I did was I picked out some papers that I have, and I got some, you know, different reds, nothing major. I'm going to use it. And then I have a piece of, with a werewolf hand. Look at that. Like a claw. Ooh, I better save that for something else. That's going to be for a creepy mixed media. Yeah. So what I'm going to do, I'm using a watercolor pad that I got from, a craft store, wherever. And all I'm going to do is glue them down. Now I'm not going to use, because this has this on top, and I didn't cut it off first because I'm going to use my, make sure I cut it even, because I'm going to probably put this up for sale. I'm not going to work in probably the, you know, like an inch. So what I'm going to start to do is I'm going to open my, using decoupage from Americana. Decoupage. Fantastic. But look, I use, and I tell you guys, you can use glue sticks. Glue sticks are archival. Elmer's glue sticks. Fantastic. I love the Extreme Elmer's glue stick. You can use Mod Podge. You can use white school glue. I mix that with a little bit of water to get it a little bit more flowy. You can use Collage Podge, whatever you have. I like to use matte because I like to pile on top, but if you don't have matte, use glossy. I say put a little bit of water in there just to kind of thin it out a bit, so the gloss isn't as glossy. But hey, it's yours. Do it the way you want to do it. All right, so I'm going to just take my papers and I'll start, move this down this way just a little bit just so I can start down here. I want to make sure you guys can see it. And this is just roses, a scrapbook page of roses, and I'm just cutting it, ripping it into pieces, and I'm going to take my glue, and I'm just going for it. I don't need to cover all the white, all the paper, because I'll be painting on it as well. So I just throw the glue down, throw the paper down, and you can do a little bit on top if you want. It doesn't matter, just to make sure it's down. And I like different shapes and sizes and, you know, that kind of thing. Just make sure that you get the glue underneath. And glue it on. This just adds a great texture. Add some, a little bit of depth in the back and some color and a little bit of interest, as they say. But you can see how fast, there's no rhyme or reason. Don't think about it too much. Just pick up the mixed media papers, like I always tell you guys, that are on clearance at your stores. It doesn't matter if they're Christmas or wedding or whatever, because we paint over them for the most part. And, you know, they're just in there for a little bit of color and texture. And you can decide on how much you want. Look at that, how cool. You can decide on how much you want to add or not add. Move these out of the way for a second. Okay. And like I said, I'm just going, throwing glue down. I'm very loosey-goosey with the glue because why not? It dries clear. It's not glossy and I can lay my stuff down. And if I don't like it, I can take it up right away. Sometimes I end up putting colors together that have already been together or whatever. And if you like to do that, by all means, please do. But you see, I can just lay it down like a puzzle piece. Almost like a puzzle piece. Put some down here. Here. I've been doing mixed media for years. I started out honestly with clay. Doing polymer clay and knitting, and then I found this delicious, and I would do acrylics, just straight up acrylic. But then when I found mixed media, oh, changed my life. Opened so many doors for me. Creativity-wise. You know, so. It's just fun to do because it's almost mindless at this point. And you can make it, if you want to do abstract and all that, you can definitely make it, you know, whatever you want. I just love doing little faces and girls. But, I mean, you do whatever you like. So many things out there. So much to get inspired from. I'm just going to rip. It's just book text. You guys can go to your local library or I'm going to lay it where I see more. You can go to your local library. You can go to your book dollar store, rather. They always have books there for a dollar. Most of them I wouldn't read, but I do buy. Because I just ripped them apart. This was done. These were given to me in a random act of kindness. But I got tons of books from the dollar store that I buy. And sometimes I will take some of the pages in it. Like leave the book together. And I'll go in and antique some of those pages. Which I love. I love that look. And other times I just rip them out and do like this with it. It doesn't hurt nobody. And you're recycling in a sense, especially if you use books, you know, from the library that they're getting rid of that are too beat up and, you know, they have for a dollar, at least here they do sometimes. And, you know, we're upcycling them into a beautiful painting. I also love using them as clothes for little dolls that I do on here. I just think it's a great way to add some text, you know, some different texture with the clothes. You definitely can just use scrapbook paper. I have to say, I have been blown away with just excitement and just these warm, fuzzy feelings because so many of you lately have been doing faces and just things that you guys normally wouldn't do that you would come out of your comfort zone. Kathy Spears, she went out of her comfort zone and started drawing faces. Now she started painting the faces with paint and they are beautiful. Oh my gosh, everybody on my Facebook page and in my group, you guys posting me, you guys emailing me your pictures. Oh my gosh, I can't even name you all right now, but oh my gosh, there's nothing better than waking up or going on my phone and seeing what you guys are tagging me in. So much beautiful art. And oh, and there's a fly in here. Oh, God. Did I tell you my fly experience the other night? I probably did. Who else would I have told? But, oh, geez. So, you know, just you guys are just such a blessing to me. When you guys try my techniques and I watched part of Secrets video and she did her little mixed media and oh gosh, it just makes me smile from ear to ear. It just makes me feel like, you know, I make a difference in one person's life. It's just It's crazy. You guys don't even know what that does to me. And believe me, not much makes me feel warm and fuzzy inside. Unless I'm drinking some Jack Daniels or something. Okay, so I have, you can see, very sporadically done. Not a big deal. I'm not going all out on this. I'm going to dry it. But you definitely can cover the whole back of the whole substrate that you're using, whether you're using, whether you're using a canvas or a piece of printer paper or a piece of mixed media paper. Hello, Kelly. Welcome to Earth. And whatever you're using, you can use whatever you have, your art journal. You can cover that page up really, really good. I'm not going to do that right now. I'm just going to kind of do it like this. And you can see where I left up here so I can cut it straight. Now, I'll throw paint up there if it goes up there, but I'm not going to bother wasting glue or paper up there. And these were definitely different textures and different weights of paper. So you can see I have very thin paper from the book text. Okay, and the Americana Decoupage, dries so fast. It's delicious. So do their paints. It's just, look at that. Done. Now there's like little pieces here. You can tear. Doesn't matter. Gives you a nice little texture. Can you see that texture right here where it kind of ripped off? And that's going to grab paint. So I'm going to take some dioxine purple. Let's just call it that, shall we? Any color that you have, any color that you want. And I'm just going to, and you can see why I didn't gesso it, because I have all this down between the glue and the paper. So it really doesn't matter. I'm going to take the same brush I was using. I'm going to rinse it because I don't mind using that. And look at how pretty that is, that color. Let's get you. Yeah. And I'm just going to, now, you know what I love to do. I'm not going to lie. I'm going to spray these puddles of the color I put on there. Look at that. How gorgeous. And I'm going for it. Oh, did she say she's going for it? She did. Look how I'm doing. Just like this. Mixed media is not the same as painting acrylic painting. Now, you can definitely do mixed media with different layers of different acrylic paint and not use scrapbook paper. You definitely can. You can do whatever you want. But mixed media is mixing different medias. I have glue, I have paint, I have paper so far. That's what's going to, and I'm going to make sure I go on the sides. I can wet my brush a little bit more to make it a little bit more watery. I'm going down the sides so they're covered. So I don't have to worry about them after. Sometimes I don't. Sometimes I just kind of do what I'm doing and then, you know, we'll add more later. And I don't care that it's going on my watercolor pad down, you know, onto the next page, because that just starts me for deliciousness later. All right, so we have that. Now I'm going to spray it. Look how beautiful that color is. I'm going to spray it with some water. Now, something cool you can do right now, and I'm not going to do it, but I'm going to tell you about it. You can take alcohol in, like, percentage. I use 90% rubbing alcohol. You can use 80 or whatever you have. Put it in a bottle with some water and then spray it on here and let it dry, and you get the most delicious texture and all. I'm not going to do that right now, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my paper towel and I'm just going over. Use your, you know, rag, whatever you, your art things. And I want to show you. And you can go over if something's too dark, but you can see the red coming out and how nice that looks with it. And you can definitely wipe it. And you can spray it. Oh, let me show you. Like this one right here, for instance, it's a little dark. I'm just going to spray it with water right there. And take, easier to do it this way. Take your paper and wipe it, and then you get that coming back out, and you can see it wipes off. So you can definitely, you know, go back and wipe off some of your papers. You don't, not all of them, because you want that to come through with the text. I mean, look how beautiful that is. But you can definitely go back and give everything a little wipe if you want. So you can still see that beautiful purple. But it's, you see how it's coming together a little bit? And then save your, I use paper towels, cheap paper towels, but I save them because I, once I use this all up and it gets all different colors, then I will use it as a background. So don't forget to do that. This is, I love recycling and using things over and over because I'm crazy like that. All right, so I have that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit it with my heat gun. As always, I tell you guys, if you don't have a heat gun, use your hair dryer. Go to the thrift store for $2 and buy a used hair dryer. Heat gun is for when you emboss. That's really the main reason of a heat gun. A lot of people have heat guns to dry with, and I love my heat gun. I need a new heat gun soon, matter of fact. But, you know, you just, it's really hot, and that's good. That's why I moved it around so much. But like I said, a hair dryer will work just as good, or even a fan, like one of those fans you get at the dollar store that you turn on, like a personal fan. Definitely. Or you just leave it dry like we used to do before heat guns. It'll only take 5-10 minutes, and maybe you'd use your time wisely and clean up your desk like I never do. Okay. The reason I'm drying this, a lot of you guys ask if I'm doing mixed media and the end result is kind of already messy looking, I guess is the word I want to use. Not in a bad way, but why do I bother drawing it? And it's because I want that purple to come out. Now look, see, some of this paper's coming up. I'm just going to give it a tear. Look at that. Nothing. That comes off. Now I can re-glue that down if I want. I'm not, but I enjoy this because it's going to grab color. But I don't do it because I dry it because I don't want to mix the colors, the next color on, and then get it to be muddy looking. If you're looking for that kind of look, I say go for it. I don't think there's anything wrong with it, but I like to do it, you know, that's just how I do it. Sometimes I don't. Sometimes I make it muddy. I don't care. Depends on my mood. Alright, so I'm going to try, let me grab, let's see, some yellow and some blue hue. Now I'm going to go with yellow first. And I'm going to put it there because, and this is just any yellow you have, because that's where I want it to be bright. I want it to kind of, where it's lighter at, I just want to add a little bit of yellow. Now, it's not going to be bright yellow. And if you want it to be bright yellow, by all means, use yellow first rather than purple. Because you always, you know, think about it, especially if you're starting out, always go light to dark. I like to do light to dark, but you know, sometimes I just do like this. But see how I'm going to add that and see how it kind of blends. And I'm just blending and blending. And it's just going to add another kind of depth and color. I'm not going to put it everywhere. Just some lighter areas. But see how that adds like a little bit of, I don't know, a little bit of something, something. Who doesn't like something, something? Now, what I like to do, I like to just give it a quick spray of water. That's how I do it. You don't have to. You can leave it dry like this, or you could just leave that little blob that I totally didn't see, and I'm just going out with my fingers. Look at that. No harm done. And then I'm going to just give it a quick dabby dab. Now, if I wouldn't have, now look how cool that looks. If I wouldn't have done the dry, if I wouldn't have dried it, it would become muddy looking. Like for instance, let me show you. I'm going to put a little bit of like a turquoisey blue down. I'm going to do it right here so you guys can see it. And when I go to put that in, it's mixing. And what's it doing? It's making it green, which is completely fine. But that's, I want the color. So I'm just going to kind of use my fingers, and because I use my fingers a lot, just kind of spread that out. I'm not going to hate on that. I'm going to use it to my advantage. And that gives me a whole other color. That's why I always tell you guys, when you're new to this and you want to go buy paints to start mixed media, always do Roy G. Biv black, white, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, and black and white. Don't figure out the words because it's indigo violet, but I don't do it. I just smush them together as purple. And you can really mix all these colors together. I mean, I just made a delicious green there. So, you know, and you can adjust that with white and different colors to really make a different, you know, pastels colors and all that. So real quick, I'm just going to give it a quick dry. I know what I'll do next, though. Yeah. This is gorgeous. I hope you guys can truly see, like, how gorgeous this is already. Just this background. Tooting my own horn, I must be doing. I love mixed media. I love everything about it. Now, I'm going to put this on as I'm going to put this on live as the longer version. And then I'm going to do a quick version for those who don't want to watch the longer version, but want to watch me create a mixed media background. Sometimes people don't, you know, sometimes you're like, oh, you know, I don't want to sit for 45 minutes, but I want to see what happens. And that's what we're going to do. All right. I'm going to grab a stencil. This is Americana stencil in tie-dye, which is really, really cool. And what I'm going to do... Now, when you have stencils... Okay, when you have stencils that are this big, now you can do several things. I can sit and I can fill all this in, right? So it has all that. Or you can do different parts. And what I'm going to do on this one is different parts. And I'm going to use some modeling paste, whatever you choose to call it. I have a great recipe for making your own with baby powder and white school glue and white paint. And you mix all that together. I have it on my website. I'll try my best to remember to link it down below. But it's great. And if you can't afford to go out and buy it, you can definitely use it. I love the... texture paste from DecoArt, but you use whatever you want. And I'm just going in like this, and I'm just sporadically. And see how I don't care if it gets a little mush. I'm just kind of doing it. When you have big stencils like this, you want to hold them, you know, hold them kind of down where you're at. I always like to scrape, but because there's so many holes in this, so many texture areas, you know, it's going to get caught. It's all right. It's not the end of the world. I just went a little bit. As you can see, nothing major. Now, I'm going to lift this up. See how that looks? Just going to add that little bit. But I don't have anything up here. So real quick, I'm going to go in and just fill in some of these up here so the texture goes up there as well. And I'm not worrying. I'm not getting that full I'm not going for what the stencil looks like. I just want the texture. And that is totally up to you. You can do whatever way you want. Okay, I want a little bit down there. Okay. Now, normally I say if we're using paint or sprays, I don't clean my stencils. But however, when I'm using something that's going to dry pretty hard, and this is a new stencil, I'm going to wipe it off because I don't want to ruin it with, you know. So all I do is, I'm going to move this for a second. Just going to show you guys. Give it a second to dry. I'm going to lay this down. And you can use your, you know, water or whatever. And I'm just going to give it a nice wipe on this side. And if it starts drying, just spray water on it. There's really no easy way to do this. Some people have a container of water sitting next to them where they put it in. And I say, hey, more power to you. I think that's fantastic. Me, on the other hand, I can't swing that. I would never use it. I'd end up spilling it. My dogs will be drinking out of it. It's just not going to work. So, and then do the back. And I know it's on the mat, and that's okay. I'm just going to kind of... This one's got a lot of holes, so it's a little bit... You just don't want no big chunks. That great, then you just wipe it off. And because it's on our mat here, you know, our nonstick mat, it'll come off easy even after it dries, so I don't worry too much. And then I go back. I know it seems like a lot, but it's, you'll be glad you know, did the wiping. And I'm just going to go off one more time and just wipe where. Or like I said, spray it with water and leave it sit till you're done working. Done painting and all that, and then go back and wipe it off. But I'm happy with that. I'm not complaining. It'll be good for me next time I use it. Now, back to this. Okay. Now I'm just going to hit it with my dry. You don't have to. You can leave it dry. Yeah, it's fairly quick, so. Now think about, I'm going to use my Dilutions ink spray in Bubblegum Pink. But think about something that you have, maybe a color that you like or spray that you like. And I'm going to show you how I'm going to do it. If you have sprays that you have, like if you have sprays that you really love, you know, you can definitely use them with your brush. But I want these dry. I'm not going to sit and bore you as I dry all of it forever, but. Okay. Now, I'm going to grab one more color. All right. Okay, so let me start with, I'm going to use my Dilutions in Lemon Zest. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to pick it up. I'm going to take a brush. And you can pull from here or even stick your brush in the bottle. It doesn't matter. And kind of, yeah, it's still a little damp, but that's all right. Now you can definitely go spray if you want. Let me show you. I like doing this because it adds the color very bright and it's not all over the paper, but it's on my white. But if you don't have patience, watch. If you don't have patience, just give it sprays like that. And then I'm going to use the bubble gum. See, that comes out. Leaks all over me. I don't understand why. But when you spray, sometimes it gets a little bit more than over more than I want it to be. But what I'll do is just take my brush again, dry my brush because I don't want it to be too wet. And then kind of, because it's it's not permanent. I can lift it up. I'm gonna paint if it missed anywhere. Just put it over, I'm not worried. And then what we'll do is, you can see that it's still a little bit wet. And I like the yellow, I like all the colors blending and mixing and okay. That is a boom in your face page, no? Now take my paper towels, where you're at. Just give it a little. It dries very fast, so, but you're still getting up a little bit, and that's what I want. And I don't care if it adds more texture to the molding paste. I just want that little bit of deliciousness. Now, here's what I want to show you. I want you to look at this. I know it's hard to see as I'm doing it. Can you see all the, you could see the paper that we started with, right? All the paper that we started with, and then all those layers under there and on top. And it's just, look at that. Oh, I'm sorry. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Now, what I'm going to do is I want to do a face on here. So what I'm going to do, because why not over all this color? Why am I not going to do that now? I'm going to take my smaller brush. I'm going to rinse it. I'm going to dry it. And always make sure you wipe, your feral, is this called a feral? I know we have feral cats, but I don't know. It's called something, your paintbrush handle. Wipe it when you wipe off before you paint, because a lot of times water will be up here, or barrel, I don't know what the heck it's called, and then it runs. So I'm just going to take some warm white acrylic paint and decide where I want to kind of start my face at. I think I'm going to do it down here. And I'm just going to do a small, I'm not going to do too much. I'm just drawing with this. Color it in. It's going to pick up. It's going to pick up a lot of the color underneath, and I don't care. I should probably shake this first. Sometimes that paint separates. And this is just a matte, you know, like a regular acrylic paint. Nothing. In. I like it's picking up all that paint, but if you don't want it to, make sure you dry and do a gesso down of this first, and then go to town. But I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to just use my paint as my guide right now, as you know. Can you hear my shirt, my thing creaking? My seat, my shirt, what the heck, hell. My shirt's creaking and my bones creaking. Okay, and that's what I'm going to do. That's going to be her hair. And then I don't want, just kind of want to pull that together. All right, so now I'm going to paint all that, and then I think I'm going to do, paint that. Oh, there goes my stomach now making gurgling noises. I'm a hot mess today. All right, make sure those go off. Now, what I'm going to do, I think, is take a bigger brush right now. I'm going to dry it. It doesn't have to be too dry, though, because what I'm going to do is just take it, that warm white, and what I'm going to do is kind of just paint this, because I'm going to do this a color. I don't know what color yet, but that's just me kind of, you know, I do that because I'm sketching in what my thought process is, but yeah, all that texture under there, delish. Oh, excuse me. Thank you, April Payton. Every time I sneeze, she always tells me bless you on my comments. I love it. Oh, I love it. Go check out April Payton. She has some good videos. All right, I'm liking it. I'm liking it. All right. So that's kind of there. I can see here. A little bit sticking up. And all right, so I have to dry that. So let me dry that. Can you see underneath all that texture right there? Now, of course, it wasn't all the way dry, so it's smushed a little bit, but it's still texture, and I don't care. That's the fun of mixed media. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to dry it and then go over it one more time with that color. It's still going to pick up some of that delicious color underneath, and that's okay, but I'm going to concentrate more on the face and not the hair, because the hair I'm going to do a darker color anyway. But I do want this dry a little bit. Another fun thing to think about is when you're doing mixed media, I mean, I can see in here, I don't know how well you can see it, but it's like almost like a sunburst. You know, you could paint like a, put a, I could do that. I could put a, like a crystal in here and then bring out some yellow, like her, oh geez, okay. I get excited when I think of different things. Like, oh, I can do that. Oh, I could do this. All right. Now I'm just going to paint one more time in her face just to make it a little bit more Oh my God, my chair. It's so funny. And that's kind of given me where her hairline's going to be. Do you see? So I don't have to, you know, worry about that. I can just go in and paint. Paint her face, let's paint the face. Yeah. Yeah. All right. Okay. Yeah, see how that just a little bit, and it's still going to come through. I'm not going to worry too much, and then I'm going to go down her neck one more time. Now, just do this in your art journal, and don't worry even about doing the back mixed media background if that's not your gig. You know what I mean? Totally up to you. So now what I'm going to do is draw the face one more time. You can still see that dilution's coming through. I'm okay with that. There's texture. I'm okay with that. I'm okay with it. Are you okay with it? We're okay with it. Yes, we are. So what I want to do now that tapping is just my cord from my heat gun hitting. I know a lot of you get annoyed. You'll be like, what's that noise? It's just me being me. All right. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to start with the face. Now, let me move in a little bit. This is not by any means, you know, you do whatever you want, however you want. I say use a water-soluble pencil or a pencil itself. I'm going to use a pencil today because a lot of you have said to me, have asked me to use pencil rather than my water-soluble pencil because you guys don't have one, and I totally get it. I'm not about hating. So I just have my delicious Papermate Clear Point 0.7. I use 0.7 the most. I love 0.9. 0.5 breaks on me because of my hands and the stress and pressure I have to use. But you use whatever you have. All right. So here we go. Real quick tips. Quick tip. Okay. You can see her face is kind of angled, like when we're sitting straight. I have it turned so it's facing me straight right now. And that's the best way I can tell you to do it. But what we're going to do is go into her face. Just put a paintbrush there or a pencil, okay? And where her chin is, that's going to be the middle of the face, right? Don't go by the hair necessarily. Now, you can, there you go, make it a little bit like that because her face is going to be, you know, she's looking a little bit different. But all you have to do is go in, do a line on either side. See how we're doing that? Very simple. If you want to measure if you're even, you can do like that. I'm not going to worry about it too much. She's whimsical. She's doing her thing. Whatever. All right. So then I have that. And I'm going to take it down and I'm going to do her nose about here. Okay. And then I know that her mouth, you can measure it still, but I'm going to do her mouth around here. And that's how I'm going to do that. Now, what I'm going to do is, there are a million ways to do this. I get asked this question more times than I pee during the day or more pee during the night. All right. Too much information. I draw the lines because that's where I gauge my top and bottom eyelid. However, you can make this your top eyelid. Right? Look. You can definitely do this like this. And that's just so they're even. It doesn't matter. We'll do that today. I just do that because then I know I can do, you know, hit those corners. You want to make the corners. You know, but no big deal. No big deal. I'm going to erase this a little bit. That corner's a little much. Just do like that. And then the nose. I see the nose. You guys know I erase so I can just barely see the line. But, you know, you can do the nose in so many different ways. Let's do just a little nose right there. Okay. I can see now what I like to, I like to look, sit back and look, and I can see it's a little off because of the way the face is shaped, but I'm okay with that. I'm just going to do like that. And then the mouth, as always, do it whatever way you want. You could do your two circles and your oval. You can see I have some modeling paste there, molding paste, whatever you call it. And then I just go in and do my lips. And then I'll erase that middle. Now you can see some of that came off. The modeling paste came off a little bit when I, but it's no big deal because I'll be painting these in and I'm not worried about it. You just kind of go back and do that. And you have your face basically in. No big deal. And then just erase those lines. So you can do it that way or you could do it the other way. It doesn't matter. I always erase anyway. The pencil or whatever, you know, unless I want to blend that in, but no big deal. And then the eyebrows will be up there. So let's work on the eyes first. So take some white. You can definitely use a white marker or you can use white paint, whatever you have. Sometimes I paint them in. Sometimes I do the eyeballs first. Depends on whatever mood I'm in. White is sitting right in front of me, so. And it also acts like a gesso. Okay, and if you want to go in for the lips to like kind of give them a little bit of a gesso-y vibe going on in there before you pick the color that you want, by all means. Never hurts. There we go. She kind of looks ghost-like. Ooh, yeah. I'm not going to do her ghost-like, but that gives me an idea for another one. Look, I'm a ghost. I'm a ghost. Oh, no. All right, so I'm going to draw her eyes and her lips. And the same color I'm probably going to paint her hair, I'm probably going to do in her eyes. See, now what I would do is take my water-soluble, my water-soluble pencil. And I would trace these and I wouldn't put anything in there and I'd leave them run like she's crying. That's what I would probably, I'm not going to do that now for Love Summer Art. We're going to make it kind of summery and deliciousness and I'm not going to do that right now, but I might do one later in a different kind of way. All right. So now I'm just picking up blue hue, which is this color, just a blue, whatever color you want to do the eyes. I'm just going to go in and paint circles in for the eyes. I'm not going to worry about it too much. It's just my, you know, I'll put another layer on, another color. I like to sometimes put glitter or, you know, lighter colors in. So it has a little bit of dimension. But that'll be her eyes right now. Look at her. She's like, oh no, a ghost. All right. So now this is the color I'm going to use for the hair. And all I'm going to do is go like this. Very fun. I'm going to rinse my brush. I'm going to get most of the water out. Not too much. Don't want too much water in there. But I'm just going to go for it. And kind of. I'm into faces lately. I'm doing all kinds of different faces. I don't know why. I got my Etsy started. With some stuff. I gotta just do a few more things till that goes live. I got a lot of stuff I'm gonna get up there. Great prices. I'm not looking to get rich. Just want to get rid of some stuff. I made some paintings in case anybody wants any. And you know, everybody will make out. I love it. I freaking love it. Freaking love. Okay, we're gonna let that dry. Now let's decide the lips, the lips. What color going to the lips? I say let's do. Let's see. How about just some red? I just can never have enough red lips. Sorry. Not sorry. All right. So I'm just going with whatever kind of red you want. Don't want my brush too much. Brush much. I'm holding my brush like a pen, like, you know, when you're learning how to write and they tell you that's how I'm doing it for the small parts that I do. That simple. Now, I don't, you know, I don't have a little bit left here. I can put it on my brush and I can go anywhere. It's just going to add some of that red in there, blend it out a bit. Why waste it? Why not use it for some goodness? Just adds a little something, something. All right. Now I'm going to dry this and work on the nose. Now, I'm going to go in and give her bangs a little bit across this way because it's too much on her forehead. But I could also put a stone there or something if I wanted. But and I love underneath here where you can see the dilutions coming through where it mixed with the blue and it made it purple. Love it. Okay. So now I'm going to take my brush. That's the smallest one. Gotta find my smaller one. Here it is. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna lightly erase this nose, just very lightly, because I don't want to peel the paint up because it's not cured. Okay. And then I'm gonna take a color. No, not that color. Maybe I'll, what color do I want to use? Yeah, Let's see. I'm going to use some Bambi Brown. And that's all it looks like. Okay. A little bit on the tip. Wipe it off a little bit. A little bit of her nose. Like that. And then I'm going to take a little bit more, wipe my brush. I'm going to go over these. Give her some eyelids. Oh, my stomach will not stop today. Like that. And then a little bit of eyebrows. Okay. I'm going to take a little bit and outline her face a little bit. You can do this in a black marker or whatever you want. I might even go over it with black marker again. Who knows? Who knows with me? Just adds a little bit of I would love if you guys did this along with me and tag me in what you guys do. I love seeing what you guys do. You guys are so creative. You know, with your own thing. All right, so I'm going to leave that like that for a second. I'm going to take a little bit more blue for that face. Oh, there goes my camera moving. Hello, hello, hello. I'm going to take some blue. Let's take a couple coats of this right here. But I might go over and do her eyebrows blue too. I don't know. I'm just going to lay that in. Turn my brush a little bit more. And then I'll highlight. I should have put some texture in there, but that's all right. Pull it up. You know what I want to do? I'm going to do that. I want it to still be somewhat. I'm going to put a little bit of the modeling paste in there. Kind of wipe that off. Sometimes you just have to adjust. I'm going to take a little bit. And I'm going to take it over that edge. Give it a little bit of texture. So it blends. Like that. And I think just a little bit going up. Because as it goes up, it doesn't need as much texture. But I can throw that through. Always okay to change your mind. Well, this is an hour you're not getting back in your life, isn't it? See, we're just adding it all the way up. Nothing, no rhyme or reason, no stencil needed. Just your fingers. And that's just going to add a little bit more when we add the blue in there. Here's what I'm trying to decide. I don't necessarily, I want her to kind of have a part right here. A fly just dived on me. All right, so I'm going to hit this with my... Keep going. And while that dries, I'm going to take and outline the eyes a little bit because I want them to stand out a little bit more. I like it without the, I like it without underneath, but I don't know. Decide these things before I go and start thinking I know what I'm doing. Let's see if I can get this off. Last time I did this, I ended up with a little eyeliner thing going on there. Yeah. I don't need a fully lined. Just the top. That's what I'm gonna do. Do the top. Give her pupils. Give her pupils. Okay, and then I'll finish up her hair right here, and that'll be all that I'll torture you. I don't know what I'm going to do with the rest of her, but if I finish it, I'll put a picture up in the video. Right now, I'm just going to throw some more of this blue on it. My brush is wet because I want it to spread out thin. I don't need it to be so thick. I just really want to cover the texture. I might put flowers in her hair. I don't know. A little bit more down here. You can still see the dilutions coming through. I'm just going to kind of roll this in a circle here to get this in here. I like that much better. Much better. Okay. That's all I'm going to do with her right now. And I don't know. I'm going to have to let her dry and figure out what next. But this is her. Just a mixed media girl. No big deal. She has crazy hair. Deciding whether I want to bring some pieces down, put some molding paste, and put pieces of the blue hanging down. I don't know. But right now, she's pretty good. I'm just going to give her a highlight in her eyes and figure out that part. But not bad, not bad. Thank you so very much for hanging with me. Hanging with me. We were hanging today. And I'm going to try to get her done, and I will put a picture on the video. If I don't have the picture on the video, it's all over my social media. I'm sure I'll post it. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest. Where else? I do have a Tumblr. I don't use it often. But, you know, I'm all over. So look down below in the About section down below, and you will find my links. And come join me. I love to follow back. I love to see what you guys do. And if you do anything like this, just tag me so I can see what you do. That's it. I love you guys, and I will talk to you later. As always, be kind to each other. You never know what battle somebody else is fighting. Bye, guys.